Very good morning to you all. I am Lakshmi Narayana Gunta, PGT in Zoology at APMS and Junior College, Karavanja. I am also working for NEET Super 60, Srikakulam. Today, the topic of our discussion is Periplaneta americana, the American cockroach. It belongs to phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Orthoptera, family Blattidae, genus Periplaneta and species Americana. They are nocturnal, means they are active during night time and they rest during daytime. And Periplaneta Americana, it acts as scavenger. It prefers dark, warm corners of kitchen, godowns and also places where food and humid atmosphere are available. And even though these Periplaneta americana, they were the natives of America, but they have been distributed all over the world today. That's why they are cosmopolitan in distribution. The body of these cockroaches, it is dorso-ventrally flattened body and elongated and reddish brown in color. They easily creep inside small crevices and cracks. And males, they measure 35 to 40 millimeters in length, whereas females, they measure in between 29 to 37 millimeters in length. The difference between a male cockroach and a female cockroach is, the male cockroach, it has slender abdomen with wings extended beyond the abdomen, and whereas the female cockroach, it has a broader abdomen with shorter wings, and whereas anal styles, which are present in males, they are absent in females. And these anal cerci, they are present both in males and females. These are the basic differences between a female cockroach and a male cockroach. They are segmented, and these segments, they are organized to form three distinct tagmata. These tagmata, they are the head, thorax and the abdomen. These three, they form the tagmata. All the three tagmata, they are enclosed by exoskeletal coverings called as sclerites. Here you can clearly observe the head, the thorax and the abdomen. The head of Periplaneta americana is a triangular structure and it is a hypognathous head. Why it is called as hypognathous head? Because it is located right angles to the body and the mouth parts, they are located towards downwards. That's why it is called as hypognathous. Hypo means towards downward. The head is formed by the fusion of six embryonic segments. Top of the head is called as the vertex. Here you can clearly observe this is the vertex with two epicranial sclerites. Epicranial plates called as epicranial sclerites, which are joined with each other with a suture called as epicranial suture. Okay, and below this vertex there is a large plate, a single unpaired plate called as frons. Frons. Here you can observe the frons. This is frons. Okay, and it is the largest plate of the head. And below this frons, there is another plate, another sclerite called as clypeus, with which the upper lip of the labrum is attached. Here you can clearly observe the labrum of the upper lip. It is attached with the clypeus, which is also an unpaired sclerite. And finally, below the two compound eyes, covering the sides, below the compound eyes present a pair of genae or cheek sclerites. This one is the vertex and this one is the frons, and these are genae or cheek sclerite. Okay, a total of six sclerites are there. The two epicranial sclerites, the frons, the largest sclerite of the head capsule, and the two genae and the clypeus. A total of six sclerites are there. All these sclerites they together form the head capsule. This head capsule contains paired and unpaired sclerates. Out of these, the epicranial sclerates, they are paired, and the genia are paired, 2 and 2, 4. Prons and clypeus, they are unpaired. Total of 6 head sclerites. Let us now move to the appendages of the head. The first and third segments, they have no appendages. Whereas the second segment, it bears a pair of antennae. Here you can clearly observe a pair of antennae. Base of the antenna is called as the scape, and the second portion is called as the pedicel, and finally the many jointed flagellum. Here you can clearly observe the scape. The first segment of the antenna is the scape, the second segment is the pedicel, and the third segment is many jointed flagellum. Okay. And coming to the fourth segment, it bears mandibles. Here you can clearly observe these are mandibles. And the fifth and sixth segments, they bear maxillae. The fifth segment, it bears the first pair of maxillae. This is the first pair of maxilla. And the second pair of maxilla is present in the sixth segment, which is fused to form a labium, which is also called as the lower lip. Labrum is the upper lip, labium is the lower lip. Okay. This way, the appendages of head includes first and third segments, they bear no appendages. Second segment, it bears a pair of antenna. Fourth segment, it bears a pair of mandibles. Fifth segment, it bears first maxillae. And the sixth segment, it bears second maxillae, which is also called as the labium, the lower lip. Okay. Coming to the mouth parts of cockroach. The cockroach mouth parts are called as biting and chewing type of mouth parts. And the mouth parts includes a pair of mandibles, first maxillae, second maxillae, and labrum and hypopharynx, which is also called as the lingua. Out of these, the first three, mandibles, first pair of maxillae, second pair of maxillae, they are paired structures, whereas the labrum and hypopharynx, they are unpaired structures. Let us discuss all these one by one. First one is the labrum. Labrum, which is also called as the upper lip, which is attached with the head sclerate called as the clypeus. This is the clypeus with which the labrum is attached. And it bears gustatory sensillae on its inner surface, which are meant for tasting and holding the food. Okay. And coming to the next one, the mandibles. Mandibles, they are a pair of triangular, hard, unjointed structures present on either side of the mouth and attached with the genae. Genae means the sides, the cheek sclerates. Here you can clearly observe the mandibles. And these mandibles, they bear incising and grinding teeth, which are useful in masticating the food. Okay. These mandibles, they are attached with a pair of abductor and adductor muscles, which are useful for the movement of these mandibles. And coming to the next one, that is first pair of maxillae. This first pair of maxillae, here you can observe, this is the first pair of maxillae. They are located on the sides of the mouth, And this first pair of maxillae, it is a biramous structure with protopodite, endopodite, and exopodite. Here you can clearly observe the protopodite. This one is the protopodite, which is made up of a cardo and a stipes. These two together form the protopodite. And this one, the galia, outer hood-like galia and inner pincer-like lacina together forms the endopodite. Whereas a five-jointed maxillary pulp, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This five-jointed maxillary pulp, it forms the exopodite. Okay. And this way, it is useful for cleaning the antennae and also front pair of legs. And let us move to the second pair of maxillae. The second pair of maxillae, here you can clearly observe, they are fused to form a labium of the lower lip. Here you can clearly observe. This second pair of maxilla, it contains the upper submentum, middle mentum, and the lower prementum. Okay. it also has a three segmented labial pulp which starts with the palpiger, and the paraglossa and glossa together form the ligula. These two are paraglossae and these two, the lower two, are glossae. These glossae and paraglossae, they form the ligula. Coming to the next one, the hypopharynx. Hypopharynx is also called as the tongue or lingua. Lingua or tongue. This one is the lingua or tongue, and this is a rod-like grooved chitinous structure hanging in the pre-oral cavity between the first maxillae. These are the first maxillae. It hangs in between this first maxillae. Okay. And efferent salivary ducts opens into the salivarium at the base of this hypopharynx. Okay. These are the mouth parts. This one is the labrum, the upper lip, and this one is the clypeus with which the upper lip is attached, and this one is labium, the lower lip, and this one is the hypopharynx or tongue or lingua. Okay, these are mandibles used for cutting and incision, and these are maxillae. First pair of maxillae, this second pair of maxillae, they are formed into a labium. Okay, we have completed the head and the mouth parts. Now let us go to the thorax. The thorax of cockroach consists of three regions: the prothorax, the mesothorax, and the metathorax. Here you can clearly observe, this one is the prothorax, this one is mesothorax, and this one is the metathorax. Okay, and each segment is covered by four sclerites. The upper or the dorsal plate is called as the tergum or the notum, whereas the ventral plates, here you can observe the ventral plates, ventral plate is called as the sternum, and whereas the lateral plates are called as pleural plates. A total of four: one tergal plate, one sternal plate, and two lateral plates. Each segment is covered by four sclerites. Okay. The tergal plate is also called as notum. The tergal plate which covers the prothorax is called as pronotum. The tergal plate which covers the mesothorax is called as mesonotum, and similarly the metathorax is called as metanotum. Out of these three, the pronotum is the largest sclerite of the body. This pronotum, it covers even the neck and also part of the head. That's why it is the largest sclerite of the body. Okay, here you can clearly observe, and it bears, the thorax, it bears three pairs of jointed legs. Here you can clearly observe three pairs of jointed legs, 1, 2, 3, yeah? And two pairs of wings, the first pair of wings and the second pair of wings, and two pairs of large spiracles present in the mesothorax and the metathorax. Okay, these are the large spiracles of the body. The head is complete, the thorax is complete. Let us move to the leg, cockroach leg. There are three pairs of legs in cockroach: the prolegs, mesolegs, and metalegs. Prolegs are also called as pullers, mesolegs are also called as pivots, and metalegs, they are also called as pushers. And these metalegs, they are also called as hind legs. Okay, each leg is with five podomeres. The first podomere is called as the coxa. The second podomere is called as the trochanter, and the third podomere is called as the femur. The fourth podomere is called as the tibia, and the fifth podomere is called as the tarsus. This way, each cockroach leg consists of five podomeres, and this tarsus, the last podomere, the tarsus, it again consists of five joints. These five joints, they are called as tarsomeres. Okay. And now let us move to the wings. Cockroach has two pairs of wings, out of which the first pair of wings, four wings, and they are present in the mesothorax, and they are thick, opaque, and leathery, and they are not at all useful in flight, but they protect the second pair of wings, and this first pair of wings are called as tegmina. Okay. Here you may confuse with tergum, tegmina, and tagmata. Three words you may often confuse. The tegmina is the first pair of wings of cockroach. Stigmata are the three regions of the body, that is the head, the thorax and the abdomen. Tergum is the dorsal plate, a dorsal sclerite in a cockroach is called as tergum. Tergum, tegmina, stigmata. Okay. The second pair of wings are called as hind wings. They are present in the metathorax. The prothorax has no wings. Mesothorax has the first pair of wings. Metathorax has the second pair of wings, which are also called as hind wings. They are broad and thin and transparent and useful in flight. Okay, coming to the next one, the abdomen. The abdomen of cockroach consists of 10 segments. These 10 segments, they are covered dorsally with 10 tergal plates and ventrally with 9 sternal plates, and the 10th sternum is absent. Okay, the most important thing is 10th sternum is absent, and the 8th tergum in males and 8th and 9th terga in females are overlapped by the 7th tergum. A total of 9 terga are visible in male cockroach, whereas 8 terga are only visible in female cockroach. Okay. This finishes our the morphology of cockroach, and in our next session we are going to discuss the systems, the digestive system, respiratory system, okay, of cockroach. Okay. Now let us finish this session with few questions. The terga visible in male cockroach is 9, 4, 8 and 7. What is your option? That's right. 9 is the right option. Coming to the next question. The scleroid that lies below the vertex is genu, clypeus, epicranial plate and the frons. What is your option? Right. The frons is the correct option. Frons that lies below the vertex. Okay. And coming to the next question. The structures of cockroach helpful in masticating the food. The first pair of maxillae, second pair of maxillae and the glossae, mandibles. Your option, right? Mandibles is the right option. And here you can observe the mandible. This mandible, it consists of cutting and incision structures. Okay, that's why they are helpful in masticating the food. Okay, thank you for watching. And in our next classes, we are going to discuss the digestive system of cockroach. Okay, just go to YouTube and type Lakshmi Narayana Gunta, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Okay, thank you very much.